What would you advise someone whose heart is attached to sin?
What would I advise someone whose heart is إِنَّ النَّفْسَ الْأَمَّارَةُ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي. Every single soul has an inclination towards evil except whatever soul that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed His mercy upon that soul. So a person's heart can get attached to sinning, etc. But we find that sins become habitual. And everything needs to be built up to become habitual in practice. And it doesn't mean you can't break a habit. If a person commits himself, they can break a habit. If a non-Muslim who's been drinking for 30, 40 years can break the habit, nothing to do with Iman. If a person been taking drugs, they can break the habit. If a person been gambling, they can break the habit. Why can't we as Muslims increase in our devotion towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and break a habit? The more that you read the Quran and try to understand it in the language that you understand, ponder, reflect over, look at the ayat of iman, the ayat of zajr, ayat of punishment, of torture, of good reward, etc. Lives of the anbiya, the prophets, you find the person gains inspiration. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that believers are those individuals, إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً, they carry out and say, what they do? ذَكَرُ اللَّهِ, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَمْ يُصِرُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا, they never persist or carry on in what they used to do before. When a person understands these ayat, understands, and the person creates an awakening within the individual as we drift away from the Quran, you find inside, if it's Surah Hud, or the Imam could remind you, but the ayat there, you find that whereby a person, Imam Snoot, in his tafsir, he mentions that a man, he kissed a woman. So he came to the Prophet والسلام, and asked him, what is the atonement? What should I do? So the Prophet, والسلام, he remained silent. And then the ayat that came down established the prayer in the beginning of the day and the end of the day and the part of the day. إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَ لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. Indeed, good deeds, they blot out, they wipe out bad deeds. Indeed, there's a reminder of whoever takes heed to that reminder. The person asked the question, هَلْ هَذَا خَاصْ لِي يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, is this specific to me? Is it just for me? Or هَلْ هُوَ عَامٌ, or is it for everybody? فَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ بَلْ هُوَ عَامٌ, is for every individual. إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ, indeed good deeds, they wipe out bad deeds. Well, likewise in the end of Surah Al-Furqan that we find, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change their bad deeds into good deeds. So a person shouldn't lose focus. A person shouldn't lose despair and think, I'm not going to be forgiven. A person who killed 99 people and killed another individual, that person done what? 100 people. Handling min tawbatin, is there any repentance for me? Of course there's repentance. There is repentance. Go to the following land. Leave these people. فَإِنَّ أَرْضُ السُّوءِ, they're bad, they're wicked people who influenced you. He was a sincere individual who want you to get out. So we never know. And that's what we find that one of the ulama, one of the imams he mentioned, he was saying that in his younger days, they would go out and give da'wah to the people. And no one would respond to the call. So when he went out one day, he just found like a drunken individual and he dragged him into the masjid. So when he called him into the masjid, he didn't know at that moment, because that the roof ceiling was quite low and his smell began to become apparent, this person had been drinking. So then I thought, what are we going to do here now? You know, we've got this drunken individual inside the masjid now. So people are finding it repulsive that he's inside the masjid. Now the adhan's gone for Salat al-Maghrib. Now they want to push him out, get him out of the masjid. So they decided, look, he's in the masjid now, we can't do anything now, let him pray in the corner there. All in his own, pray there, and as soon as salah is finished, we'll take him out of the masjid. So they read the salah, and they got up to then take this and remove this man from the masjid. He was in a state of sujood. So they thought, maybe he's drunk, so he'll get up, and this will take him out. They nudged him, he didn't move. فَمَاتَ فِي حَالَةِ السُّجُودِ. The imam said, we wanted to get him out of the masjid, but Allah took his life out in a state of sajda. Allah took his life in a state of sajda. Drunken individual, they wanted to push him out, but he died whilst making sajda. That's a what? A good ending. Externally to us, it looks like he's drunk, he's this, that, and the other. But Allah knows that he may have come at that moment in time to do what? To make tawbah, to repent, to change his ways. So a person should not despair, no matter how much they are inside their life. They should always persevere and return back to the house of Allah and make tawbah, make forgiveness, make repentance, and carry on, because kullu bani Adam khata' wa khayru khata'in at-tawwabun. All the sons of Adam will err, make mistakes, but the best of those individuals are those who repent. Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin. Allah loves those who repent, loves them. Those who repent and those who cleanse and purify themselves, inshallah. Wallahu a'lam.
Look who I bumped into.
My teacher. One of my beloved teachers helps me on a day-to-day basis. Inspires me to become better.
No, I got toothpaste.
Chef Dawah.
You're a lot taller in person, you know.
I just said that.
To be honest, the first time I met you, like 2 years ago. Yeah, man. Two years ago.
It's been longer than that.
Probably
grown.
Yeah, what nationality are you?
Kurdish Pakistani.
He's not Pakistani.
MashaAllah.
Yeah, you don't look.
No, you don't.
Honestly,
you don't. Sorry
to burst your bomb, bro.
No,
you don't.
I'm on the north,
isn't it? These two brothers, you might have seen them as well.
Where?
On the sheet.
Nasheed? What Nasheed?
Laura, bruv, we're trying to say
hi. Yeah, bringing up my careers.
And the people that inspired them was Sheikh Dawah over there.
Bro, if that was the case, I'd have a YouTube channel.
Oh, Sheikh Musa Abon. Sheikh Lala?
Yeah, to be honest, it was Sheikh Lala over here.
What's it, the Lala?
He made that famous video with like all sand and sugar and...
Give her a shake.
She's giving the seerah. Let's go there.
Madness. Alright, Salaam Alaikum.
If you want to get this on YouTube, watch this bro over here.
Salaam Alaikum. Salaam Alaikum.
Forget what he said about
yourself.
Yeah, obviously.
He's a legitimate. Ya man huwa murshidi Ayqantu anna ilayka maradi wa mawadi Fa'ashiqtu kulli hurufi kitabika mutadi ومقتدي بنبيك الأمين يا ربي يا من هو مرشدي أيقنت أن إليك مرادي وموعدي فعشقت كل حروف كتابك مهتدي ومقتدي بنبيك الأمين.
He's drinking out of the water.